love of Christ shall, one, tribulation, two, distress, three, persecution, four, famine, five, nakedness, six, peril, seven, or sword. You know, whatever Satan does, whatever the messengers of Satan do, they have only one goal, only one purpose, to separate you from the love of Christ. You love Christ because he loved you, because he gave himself for you, because he suffered for you, because he went through that agony on your behalf, because he bore your punishment, because he's gone to heaven to make a place for you. That's why you love him. And Satan doesn't like, love, admire Christ. And anyone that puts their love, their desire on Christ, their affection on Christ, Satan hates it. The only reason, maybe you are wondering, why all this? Why all this? Why all that? Is because of your love for Christ. And whatever Satan does, his goal ultimately is to separate you from the love of Christ. He will try, but he will not succeed. He will fail. He has failed already. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? As we read that verse, maybe you want to think. Think about people, people, people who, somewhere around you, somewhere around your home, who is that person, a rival to Jesus Christ? Think. Look through life. Who is that person? Who is that man? Who is that woman that the devil will identify? That the devil knows you love him so much. It's so much part of you. If he says, I quit, then you say, if you quit, what am I doing here? If that person says, I'm leaving, it's likely you say, if you're leaving, what am I doing here? The devil will make use of somebody in your life that you love more than Christ. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? As you think through life, and you think about everybody that you know, anybody that is close to you, is there somebody that if the person quits, if the person leaves the kingdom of God, that person will be able to have enough power, enough magnetism to draw you away from the Lord? That's what Paul was saying. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Then he begins to bring out something. Number one, tribulation. You know that tribulation doesn't just rise up from the dust. Tribulation comes through people. And then distress, that doesn't just come in the air. It comes through circumstances and situations and people, the society. And then it goes on. The Lord had told us before that, you know, some little problems will arise. The people of the world, they kick up something, they raise up something, but all those things they raise up will not be able to separate you from the love of Christ. Let's see them. Matthew chapter 10. Matthew chapter 10, verse 22. And ye shall be hated of all men for his name, for my name's sake. You know that's something that gets against our heart. We love people to love us, to smile at us, and to greet us, and to be friendly with us, and to say good morning, how are you there? We want people to fellowship with us and to appreciate us. What if, because you have become a Christian, because you are now a child of God. And the news has spread that you are now a child of God, a follower of Christ, a lover of Christ, and that your soul, your mind, your heart is dedicated unto the Lord. Your evenings are for Bible study, prayer meeting, this or that. You are in the house of God, and they come to look for you, they cannot find you. And then that person that was your bosom friend said, I came last night, I couldn't find you at home. Where did you go? Oh, I've become a Christian now, a believer now. I went for Bible study. I went for prayer meeting. I went for night vigil. I went to worship the Lord. I went for whatever. In the house of God. And that fellow said, that's what you want to be doing now? If we're going to remain friends, you have to reconsider that. And then you say, but you know, it's so wonderful to serve Christ, to love the Lord, and I've made up my mind, this decision is going to be forever. And that fellow just gives you a kind of look, belittles you as if the ground should open and should enter in. That thing hurts. It hurts. Hatred. And then he begins to spread it all around. It's gone to the fanatical people. It's gone with the people that swallow the whole Bible. It's gone with the people that believe the whole Bible. It's gone with the people that practice every letter and every jot and every tittle. That man is crazy. And everybody begins to show that hatred. What are you going to do at that time? That's what the Lord is talking about. The tribulation, the distress, the injury that comes to our heart. When those persecutors, when they just boycott us, separate us from their company. In Matthew chapter 10 verse 22, and ye shall be hated of all men for my name's sake. But he that shall endure to the end shall be saved. Will you endure to the end? I can tell you will by the grace of God. John chapter 16. In John chapter 16, verse 33. These things have I spoken unto you, that in me ye might have peace. In the world ye shall have tribulation. You know the reason why I love Christ? He doesn't hide anything from us. He tells us the plain truth. He says, as there is day, there's going to be night. He doesn't deceive us. As there is dry season, so there is going to be rainy season. He does not deceive us. As I love you, so the world is going to hate you. As I'm taking care of you, the world will try to put pressure on you. Christ is sincere. He doesn't paint a picture that is not real. In the world ye shall have tribulation, but be of good cheer.
You have received the message from our pastor, Pastor W.F. Kumoye, the General Superintendent of the Parallel Bible Church. It is my wish that as you listen, you accept the old word and you will let them sink into your hearts. And by the grace of the Lord, you will never regret it. It is my prayer that by next week, when our pastor shall come up again to present another message, you will be there, your family will be there, and your friends. And I believe as you are listening to the message every week, by the grace of the Lord, you will never be the same. Let us pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, we thank you, O Lord, because of today's message. We thank you, O Lord, because of the one you let us listen to last week and the one we are going to listen to the next week by the power in the blood of Jesus Christ. If you tarry, we shall listen together once again next week. And if not, every one of us will be there with you in the kingdom of God in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, because you are the Lord that answers prayer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.